Cap or a beverage cap. So actually I used to use two different types of designs for you creating these caps. Let's say here we have one. This is a normal cap and this is the other one. You can see the difference. Let me show you how to see this. See, this is one type of cap and this is one type of cap where we have this sharp protrusions over here, and these are somewhat softer, and even when you go for inside it will appear like this and this looks like this. So let's go and see how to create these two caps. Okay, let me firstly hide this, take a new part. And by the way, I recently bought this 2016 SolidWorks software. It's very nice and pretty useful. So now I'm taking top view as my reference and I'm creating a sketch. In my top view, I'm creating a circle. Okay, let's see here again. I've taken a circle. Dimension, take dimensions according to you. Here I'm taking a 10 centimeter dimension. Going for features and go for extrude. In extrude I'm taking the extrude length of 20 mm and at a draft angle of 10 degrees. Okay, here what we have here. And next thing, I'm adding a fillet with a radius of 10 mm. Done. The next thing, I'm going to my top view, top plane, and I'm creating a sketch again. Here, before creating the sketch, I'm taking a reference, a horizontal line. So let me convert this as a construction line. I'm going to create a small sketch like this. First I'll give an angle, let it be 5 degrees, and this value over here, see, so let's say this has 5, and the distance between these two points will be around 52, right? Okay, now what I'm going to do is just go for mirror entities. I'm selecting everything. I'm saying mirror entities. So since I have my construction line in between, so it directly mirrored the entities and created the sketch. Just come out of the sketch, select this sketch, go for extrude. Here in the end condition I'm saying yes to all and say okay. So I got one sketch here, right? Now the next thing I'm doing is quickly I'm going for a circular pattern and I'm selecting features. The feature will be this extrude and the parameters, the reference will be this, and let me take around 20. I'll go for my top view for seeing this 20. Let's decrease board to 18. Yes, 18 will work for us. So I've created this. Now I'm going for my front view. After going to front view, what I'm doing is I'm just creating a sketch like this. Okay, now after creating a sketch like this, this point will be in coincident to this point. Make coincident. Yes, this will be coincident to a straight line, and these two will be in tangency. So I've created this sketch and taking line command, and I'm creating an outline sketch. done, and I'm taking again a line command in the center to create a construction line. So let's make this as a construction over here like this. Now after doing this, I'm going to my features and I'm saying revolve cut. Revolve cut. I'm taking 360 degrees as my reference. Yes, so we got the revolve cut. Now after doing this, I'm going for fillet. I'm selecting this edge. Let's say I'm going for this. So it has selected all the edges accordingly. And see, okay. This is the first thing, and second time I'm going to fillet again. I'm selecting this edge over here and I'm going for same reference. But this time it gonna increase to, let's say, 5 mm, so that we'll get that sharp edge after creating that fillet, and say okay when we are done. So once when you are done with this, just go for your shell command and create a thin profile. See, I'm going for shell, select the face, let's go for 0.2 mm and say okay. Yes. So the last thing will be adding the appearance. Let's say I'm going for some color like this, or I'll go for an yellow color. Right, so select your color for illumination, give some reflectiveness so that you feel it is appearing real. And the next thing will be for your convenience. Here I just want to add my own logo, so I'm adding my decal. So I'm going to browse, select your logos and paste it. Let's say here I'm using SolidWorks. So for aligning this, I'm going to my top view, just rotate it here according to the size you want. You can just increase it, maximizing to that, and see, okay. So this is one step. If you want, you can go for the appearance. So this is how we create type 1 of our cap. And the next thing is this one, the one which we are seeing here with quite sharp edges over here. So I'll take a new part here, new part. In my top plane, I'm taking a sketch. In the sketch, I'm just creating a circle. Let's say we'll take diameter of 100. Done. Now I'm taking a circle which is in concentric, and I'll give the dimension as, let's say, 90. Right. Now I'm making this circle as construction line, and I'm creating an arc. I'm just creating it outside so that it won't create any unwanted relations. And now I'm just adding the relations, like make coincident here, and again over here. These two will be horizontal and these two will be tangency. So once when you are done with that, just go for your circular sketch pattern, and in entities to pattern, just select the arc and give your values. Let's say I'll go for 20. So when you go here and when you zoom in here, you'll see. suppose you don't want that sharper, so you can go for reduce number. So I have just taken 18 here. So once when you are done with this, 16, right? Now go for trim. See, now your sketch is in black. That means your sketch is fully defined. Done. You have your sketch over here. Come out of your sketch. Again, take top view. Go for reference geometry. Create a plane at a distance. You will see that from this side. Yes, 20. Yeah, let's say we will take around 15. Yes, 15 will work. On this plane, I'm going for sketch. I'm just selecting this construction line and I'm saying convert entities, so that it will create a sketch in this plane with reference to that sketch. Done. Okay, now we don't need this plane to appear, so just hide the plane. Now using these two sketches, we are creating a loft. This will be your first sketch and this will be your second sketch. Run. Yes. So once when you get your loft, go for your fillet command, create a fillet. Yeah, 10. Yes, 10 will work. Okay, done. When you see, yes, so this is the second type of cap. The only thing left to work is to add a shell command at this face at the desired thickness. So done. So the next thing we'll add is we'll add an appearance. Let me take, okay, we'll take the same appearance. Let's go for some illumination and I'll add some reflection. So that's it guys. Try to create for you and let me know if there are any issues when you're creating these two models. So thanks for watching.